Hey everyone, it's Justin again, and in this video, we're going to be talking about more word problems. But this time, the word problems won't just be words, they will also include shapes and figures. Even though you aren't taking a geometry course just yet, a lot of word problems and real-world scenarios aren't just written out in words for you. There will be visual clues that have to be used as well. So we're going to jump ahead a little bit and look at geometric problems where the image is just as important as the text. Our first example has no words at all, yet we're still expected to know how to solve it using only the image. In geometry, you're going to learn that two angles across from each other at an intersection of two lines are called vertical angles, and that vertical angles are always the same. So since this image is showing us two vertical angles, we can set them equal to each other. 3x plus 20 is equal to x plus 50. From this point, we just have to solve for x. So we're going to subtract x from both sides, then subtract 20 from both sides, and finally divide both sides by 2. X is 15. If you want to check our answer, we plug it into both angles. 15 plus 50 is 65. And on the other angle, 3 times 15 is 45 plus 20 is 65. They match, just like they should. Our next example looks like this. Again, we have to get all our information from the image. In geometry, you'll learn about linear pairs of angles, which form a straight line along one side. Linear pairs always add together to make 180 degrees. With that knowledge, we can say that these two angles in our image must add to make 180. Now, we just gotta solve for x. We combine like terms and we get 5x plus 30 on the left side. Subtract 30 from both sides and divide by 5. X comes out to 30. So let's check it. If we plug 30 into both angles, the left angle comes out to 110, and the angle on the right comes out to 70. Those two numbers add to make 180, just like they were supposed to, because this is a linear pair. Let's go a little deeper into geometry and do some problems involving shapes. So in geometry, you'll learn that all quadrilaterals, which are four-sided shapes, have angles that add up to 360. So if we add all four of these angles together, they should total 360. To solve, we're going to combine all of these terms together to make 8x. Then we just divide both sides by 8, and we get that x is 45. If we plug it in and check it, these two are just x, so they're 45 degrees. And these other two are 3 times 45, or 135. If we add it all up, we get 360, just like we were supposed to. Okay, let's try this one with words and an image. Here, we're told that this triangle has an angle ratio of 2 to 3 to 4. So what does that mean? It means there's some unknown amount, so that if we double it, triple it, and quadruple it, we will get the three angle measures of the triangle. In geometry, you'll learn that angles in a triangle add up to 180 degrees. Now we combine like terms to get 9x and divide that by 9, and x is 20. So that means the smallest angle is 40 degrees, the one on the left is 60, and the one all the way on top is 80 degrees. Those add up to 180, just like we knew they would. One more example, but don't worry, we're done with the shapes for now. Another type of word problem is a logic problem. Some people even do these for fun. It's me, I'm talking about me. The key to solving problems like these is writing everything out in math. James is twice Tom's age, so James's age is 2 times Tom's age. Sam is 2 years older than Tom, so Sam's age is the same as Tom's plus 2. Finally, if we add everyone's ages together, James, Sam, and Tom, the sum is 62. So we can't solve this with three different variables, but what if we replace James's age with twice Tom's age and replaced Sam's age with 2 years older than Tom? Now, there's only one variable and we can solve it. We combine like terms, subtract 2, and divide by 4. Tom is 15. So then James is twice that old, or 30, and Sam is 2 years older than Tom, or 17. So what do you think happens if we add 15, 30, and 17? All right, that was a lot of problems, and most of the information you're gonna be learning again in geometry. The point is, there are a lot of different types of problems that can be solved with a little algebra. We'll continue looking at word problems, geometric problems, and logic problems throughout this course and in the years ahead. Your goal for now, though, is just to get comfortable seeing math written in ways other than mathematical notation and learn how to translate it into algebraic equations.